Morning, Panthers. Today is October 3rd, 2024. My name is Kay.
Buenos dias. Yo soy Aaron. El jueves, el 3 de octubre.
Please stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Por favor, de la Pledge of Allegiance.
To the Pledge of Allegiance, to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yo prometo lealtad a la bandera de los Estados Unidos de América y a la República que representa, una nación bajo Dios, indivisible, con libertad y justicia para todos.
Please remain standing for a moment in silence.
Let's check out this week's celebration.
Here they are.
Happy birthday today to Edelyn in Miss Juan's class, tomorrow to Brianna in Miss G's class, Callie M in Miss Ramirez's class, and Gerard in Miss Juan's class. On October 5th, to Roger in Miss Prieto's class. October 6th, to Damari in Miss Danner's class, and Sophia in Miss Montero's class. October 7th, to Cherokee in Miss Morgan's class. October 8th, Michael in Miss Finley's class. October 9th, Anthony in Miss K's class. Also October 9th, Jada in Miss Ramirez's class. October 10th, to Jefferson in Miss Morgan's class. October 11th, Anthony in Miss K's class. And Malachi in Miss Morgan's class. October 13th, to Astrid in Miss Ramirez's class. October 14th, to Jeffrey in Mr. Pepe's class. And Caden T in Miss Parker's class. October 16th, to Isabella in Miss James' class. October 18th, Morrence in Miss Finley's class. October 19th, Tyler in Miss Alexander's class, and Giselle in Miss Morgan's class, and Catherine in Miss Pete's class. Happy birthday. These teachers also have birthdays over break. Miss Russell on October 6th, Miss Pam on October 10th, Miss Prieto on October 11th, and Miss Cash on October 12th. Make sure to tell them all happy birthday.
They have an hour. Mint Memento, Bimobile.
It landed on blue. Skay and Jeffrey, what's for blue?
Miss Montero, you want a light box?
We'll bring it to you later today.
This week's Panther tickets winners are Chandler and Miss Morgan's class.
In first grade, we have Callie and Miss Alexander's class. In second grade, we have Felicia and Miss Shoes.
In third grade, we have Stato and Miss Paint Cry.
In fourth grade, we have Splinter and Miss Juar class. Make sure to go get your prize in the office.
Yesterday, these classes had perfect attendance. Miss DeBona, Miss K, Miss Ramirez, Miss Summers, Miss True, Miss Damaris, Miss Thresh, Miss P, Miss Montero, Miss Parker, and Miss Juan. Great job.
September ended this week. Do you know what that means?
If you said time to count pink slips and attendance paw prints, you're right.
Let's see who won.
This is that ice cold.
In kindergarten, we have Miss James class with 18
points.
In first grade, we have Miss Summers class with 24. In second grade, we have Miss Finley's class with 25 points.
In third grade, we have Miss Newell's class with 29 pink slips.
In fourth grade, we have Taylor Pepe's class with 20 pink slips.
Let's check out the September perfect attendance winners.
In kindergarten, Miss Chu's class.
In first grade, we have Miss Ramirez.
second grade, Mr. Maris, and Miss Thrushes. In third grade, Miss Pete. In fourth grade, Miss Parker.
Congratulations, everyone. Today's influential person is Cesar Chavez.
There are several posters about him in the hall. Check this video out.
Cesar Chavez was born near the border of Mexico and Arizona on March 31, 1927. When he was 11 years old, the Great Depression caused many people to lose their jobs. There were migrant workers moving from place to place to find work. Life as a migrant farm worker was unsettling and tiring. Cesar's family moved to California to become grape pickers, a seasonal and unpredictable job. The hours were long and rest breaks were not allowed. There were no bathrooms or clean water to drink. However, if you complained about the conditions, you lost your job. Why is Cesar Chavez famous? As a Hispanic labor leader and activist, he is famous for his work and dedication to improving the lives and working conditions of farm workers. One important way he did this was co-founding the National Farm Workers Association in 1962. Today, it is known as the United Farm Workers Labor Union that fights to protect workers' rights. Chavez also helped organize a strike in 1965, which led to a nationwide boycott of California grapes. Eventually, the growers agreed to increase what they paid to their workers and allowed them to unionize. In honor of his life's work and leadership, he was posthumously awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 1993. He had a motto, "Si se puede," which means "Yes, it can be done." And yes, it was.
That's it for today.
Bye!
The end.